I know the golden cap, not as a patron. I designed some specialized devices for them. Kept blueprints, if anyone is curious.
Don't. I brought you tea as a courtesy to a colleague. I won't make that mistake in the future.
I'm sorry. I only thought... Never mind what I thought. Thank you for the tea.
I have to get back to the Admiral. He has news for me.
I'm getting a frequency reverberation that confounds some of my experiments. I suspect there are some kind of empty chambers beneath this building. In a district this old, anything is possible.
Corvo, my friend. Do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
It is every citizen's duty to report treasonous speech.
This place will fall apart in 10 minutes without me.
The state depends on you.
Is that so?
In any case, you can't dismiss me. I went through the books this morning and found 5 mistakes you've made.
Very well.
You're lucky I found them before the Admiral did. It's a nice old pub. These beds have seen quite a bit of use, I can tell you.
It was a milkmaid who started it. She took ill one morning after her chores, but the milk had already been delivered. That was all it took for them to wall the place off. Plague spread fast.
Master Piero has a great deal to learn in some areas. I'm sure Piero will make some lady a fine husband. Some other lady.
She dreams of freedom, and then the decks of whaling ships fast after the beasts of the sea. But alas, she's a woman.
Yet I have said little of my brothers Morgan and Custis. When they are, or you see. Morgan is the larger of the two, by slightly.
Ah, hello, Corvo. Cursed weepers, roaming all over the city.
Hello, Corvo. I expect Martin will be joining us shortly. I hate to start your day with such a strange matter, but the servants heard something last night, moving through the storm drains beneath the building. Most likely a weeper, the poor bastard. There's no hope for them once the plague gets that far along. Nothing more than a shuffling corpse full of sickness and insects, if you ask me. I'd appreciate you investigating, just to be sure it's not a nosy guardsman that's getting too close. Here's a key to the hatches. I'd send a servant down there, but they'd die of fear on the spot, I'm afraid. Maybe Piero can concoct some sort of sleep poison for your crossbow if you want to go that route.
Samuel. This machine was tossed into the river by the Admiral, but I fetched it. It appears to be working. Let's see if it is. Yes. There we go.
Corvo, my friend. Do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
This movement will have a cost. For some of us, it will be very high.
Thank you. Who went down there in the sewers? I thought I heard a weeper in there earlier. You're probably the bravest man I've ever met. Overseer Martin has arrived. He's with Admiral Havelock now. They want to talk to you.
Dust here, dust there. Feels like the whole world is dusty.
Good day to you, Corvo. Oh, I don't think I've noticed that tattoo on your hand before. It's interesting.
For the restless hand shall be raised against the common good. Downstairs, upstairs, almost done.
They stood in a circle around the candles and cut their hands to form their eyes. The blood hissed as it touched the flames.
I wonder, Corvo, do you have brothers somewhere? You left your family on Sarkonos to come here for the Empress, didn't you? There will be lasting consequences when this is all said and done. Make no mistake about that.
Corvo, my friend. Do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
My master had a very fitful night. No one sleeps well here.
Corvo, I trust you remember Martin, an overseer before, and perhaps again someday soon.
I owe you thanks for my rescue.
Indeed. You've given us a glimmer of hope, Corvo. Because we've gotten what we wanted from Campbell's journal. You've done it. We know where Emily Caldwin is being held.
The Golden Cat, of all places. A bathhouse for aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. The twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes we so desperately need.
Yes, the Pendletons have to die. But most importantly, Emily must be brought here safely so we can protect her until the Lord Regent and his entourage have been dealt with. Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally. I think it's best. Campbell's book appears to contain much more than we expected. He was blackmailing a number of highly ranked overseers. With the information in his journal, we will be able to manipulate the religious faction. The overseers will bend to our will. You've never been to the Golden Cat? No, I suppose not. Me neither, of course. Interesting. I won't ask, but the mark on the back of your hand... Are you studying the forbidden arts, Corvo? Never mind. We're all friends here. My neck still aches a little from the stocks. But I must say, you created quite an impression on the overseers during your visit. They are a nervous lot now.
that the conspirators have found a safe home here. They take great care that they are not followed. There are a few brave enough to laugh in the outsider's face, but Teague Martin is one. The ale here is sweet with honey, to hide the taste of the river rind. Do not be deceived by his talk of strictures. Martin's crimes weigh heavy on his spirit. He has been a soldier, a highway robber, and a man of faith. The sober speak in whispers, the drunk bellow. Fortunes have been won here, and lives have been lost. He wonders which is more powerful, the knife or the tongue. He always had his sights set on the Abbey's highest office. There are few brave enough to laugh in the outsider's face, but Teague Martin is one.
Corvo, a moment if I may. Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis. They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard, cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent, and as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to stop the Lord Regent from further consolidating his power. These days, they're best known for exploiting their favor with him to cheat others out of their wealth. Let's just say that not every family evicted and quarantined for having the plague actually has the plague. I warned my brothers in every way I could. I really did. But they never did listen to me. They'll be at the Golden Cat tonight at their usual revels. They'll be protected by the City Watch. So it'll be dangerous. Now go. Please do it before I change my mind. A challenge. Even for someone like you. Six months ago, I was out at the estate hunting with my brothers. Custis and Morgan were always better shots, though one of them nearly killed me, all for a cruel joke. Strange. I never thought I'd be the Pendleton heir, you know. I never expected any of this. By the outsider's eyes, I'm going to drink tonight. It'll have to be now, I think. With Campbell out of play, they'll move Lady Emily soon. And in a few days, Custis and Morgan will be out at the estate hunting. And we'll never catch them. Strange. I never thought I'd be the Pendleton heir, you know. I never expected any of this.
The old man claimed a dark corner and drank himself into oblivion. The hounds were the first to find him.
I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall whiskey factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you bring him back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo. A riverhand I know pulled up alongside me last night and said there's one of those watchtowers on Clavering now. I guess you getting rid of Campbell shook up the Lord Regent. Remember what I told you. If you need a man what knows the ins and outs of this city, especially the gutter side parts, you should find Slackjaw. Watch yourself, though.
Hey, you're just the man I was looking
for. That him?
Yeah, Slackjaw. He's the one.
Hey, we got a message for you from Slackjaw. He wants to talk at the distillery. Go on. Slackjaw's inside.
That's what they get for taking free swigs from the still. That tainted elixir is bad stuff, I guess.
It's what they call irony, I think. Elixir is supposed to prevent the plague sickness, fight it off. But someone poisoned the bootleg still, and now we got the elixir that gives you the plague.
I don't think that's what that word means, idiot.
Well, how would I know? It's some other word then. Anyway, I almost feel sorry for the poor fools that drank that bad elixir.
Thank you.
Slackjaw be waiting for you. Blow off, Chopper. Slackjaw be waiting for you. Easy, easy. You just need a bit. Ain't you heard? Slackjaw keeps the good stuff for himself. Rest of us. One part elixir, three. Parts water down. Oh, that's just to make the swallowing go smooth. Well, I ain't taking no chances on getting the plague. Drink till you drop, that's my motto. Slackjaw be waiting for you, inside the distillery. You in the mask. You look like a clown. Are you supposed to be scary?
He is a villain if I judge your looks aright. A villain I might have some work for. Somebody put plague in the brew tank. Half my men are weepers. Trapped three of them in the distillery. Rest are wandering in the street. Since it's so, and I find myself short of able bodies, I may have a point of interest for you, see? Way I figure it, there ain't nobody worth killing round here except those two Pendletons over at the Golden Cat. I'm right, ain't I? See, Slackjaw knows. Them boys are twins. Rich, mean, and weird. Worse than most of their ilk. They've been laying low there a while, not sure why. There's a lot of security at the Golden Cat tonight, though. Special guests and the like. But you're gonna walk in there, dressed like that, and kill the Pendleton brothers? Maybe I got a better way to take care of them, too. If you're doing something for me first, understand? Someone, I don't know who, is killing my men, taking my territory, stealing my goods. Might be a fellow named of Galvani. I sent my best man to investigate, but he went missing and... Well, now I need someone to find what happened to him. Go to this Galvani's place. He lives nearby, off Clavering Boulevard. You do that for me, and I'll get your better way into the Golden Cat. That Galvani is a... doctor, they call him now. Get into his office and you can find out what happened to my man who vanished. Robin ain't never been easier since the plague, but now there ain't hardly no reason to have anything. Nearly everybody's gone.
Prowling around.
smoke, or eat?
Blow off, Chauffeur.
What a mess, huh? Whole town's gone to trash.
Want to look at some of the things I've found? Good prices, I swear.
see him?
Just saw like a lot of blood, really.
Wish I saw.
Not a big deal. Maybe you can go up later and take a look, after them other two are gone.
I think he's dead, right?
I know that. I mean, do we have suspects?
Suspects? What? Suspects? We ain't gonna waste time solving who killed him. Personally, I'd buy who did it a drink.
But what are you gonna put on your report?
I'm gonna say we found one of Slackjaw's men inside, all dead and bloody, and that you are a stinking idiot.
Thank you.
What have you done to me?
Poor bastard. Stuff can't be worth nothing, can they?
Not a chance. I think I remember having seen this painting at my grandmother's place. She wasn't over Dutch.
Yeah, probably can't even tell. Not worth the time taking it off the walls. I might go upstairs, see if the mother two found something worth the trouble.
Come on, Stu. One more try. They wouldn't have such a strong door unless they kept some interesting things on its other side.
I'm telling you, it won't budge. Not even a bit. And I think I bruised out my shoulder.
Stop your crying and give another shove.
Just imagine what could be behind it. That'll get you through the pain.
If you're so sure, then you shove it. Why do people care about this stuff?
My name is Samuel.
Thank you.
A mandatory whale oil ration is now in effect. Non-compliance is a punishable offense.
Come on up. The more people die, the cheaper it gets.
Look out for the watch. They got no respect for law. Hey, wait a minute. What just occurred to me? How come it's always me who pay for the whiskeys?
Shush up your mouth. You know I can't work out the right number of coin. It's embarrassing. This information for my missing guy. Let's have a listen.
Slackjaw, it's me, Crowley. I'm making this in case I don't make it back. He was right. There is someone wants you dead. Wants to take over the distillery and the whole Bottle Street gang. And you'll never believe who it is, neither. At first I didn't. That's why it's taken me so long. I wanted to be sure, and what's that? Arr! No! No! Ah!
So Crowley's dead. Too bad. He was one of my best men. Still, you and me had a deal, and Slackjaw never goes back on a deal. Take this key. It ain't for the Golden Cat, no. This key's for the captain's chair. A hotel abandoned since the plague gutted this part of town. Take the stairs to the top. You can use the roof to get into the Golden Cat brothel. See that? Slackjaw keeps a bargain. Just as good as them men who run the city. Maybe a little better. You think about that. Now maybe we can help each other out again. I could get rid of the Pendletons for you, quiet-like and without killing them. But you gotta do something for me in return. The Cat's having a big reopening tonight. Lot of money clients, including an arts dealer named of Bunting. He's got particular tastes, or so I've been told by some of the ladies. Got some pretty fancy stuff locked away at his place, and the only thing preventing me from nabbing all that loot is the combination to his safe. Of course, the Pendletons have been camped out there for months too, not sure why. So that means a lot of the City Watch and other soldier types. Bring me that combination, my masked friend, and then I take care of the Pendleton brothers. Just like that. You ain't never even gonna touch them. And I promise, I won't kill them, and no one will ever see them again. Now if that ain't a deal, Slackjaw don't know what is.